Okay then. You're here. I am Tom. Let's write some code. Boop. Now, as you can probably tell, last time, and indeed continuing on this time, we are doing sprites. We have done the fooling sprite, and not quite sure how that looks. Kind of looks like Manic Mailman from The Simpsons rather than a lemming, but it's the best I can do with a single colour. So that's the fooling and the walking done. I now need to do the climbing, which means I should probably go back into here and let's just revert. All of this map stuff that I did. Then we can give them something to climb on. Okay. Now if we recompile, compiling is taking a little longer than usual. I guess only 13 seconds. So now they fall in and they've got two things that they can climb up. But they don't have a proper climbing animation yet. So I'm dropping frames already, aren't I? Let's close down Firefox and reopen it once OBS has had a chance to establish its dominance. So we have the map, we just need the animation. Which we are going to have to go out of the game and into our animation editor. I haven't hooked up Enter yet. Maybe that's something I do when I get a bit bored. Right, new animation. The animation name is going to be one animation name. Lemming climb. Color. It's going to be two, 8, 6, 6. D7 is lemming, yes. Create. Hello, if you've just joined us, we are going to start off today creating a climbing animation. Looks like there is a lot of climbing animation. So we've got this one here. I think most of those are different. Then we've got it reflected. This one might be climbing over the edge of something. Yeah. Interesting. I think we can leave that one for now. Then we've got the umbrella animation, which interestingly has no zombies in it at all. And we have many, many frames of explosion. Many, many, many frames of explosion. A lot of frames of blocker as well, but might just leave that as a single frame because most of them involve different colour hair to make it actually look different. So this one looks like the dig animation. Oh, is this the splat? Yeah, the splat as they fall too far. Not quite sure what this one is, probably one of the traps. Or maybe that's continued explosion? That one's interesting. I've got no idea what that is. It looks like it's... Oh! That one's climbing into the exit. Got builder here. Got one where it's shrugging. I guess that's a can't do the animation, or can't do the action animation. This one's digging straight down. Bashing. Bashing seems to be doubled up, but just like a frame later. Then we've got digging down. and some numbers. The numbers, I suspect, are the timer for when they are exploding. But anyway, back to the top. Let's go with one of the easier ones and do the climbing here. I really wish I could get a grid over the top of this. Never matter. I will quickly open up a image editor for my own reference, just so I can get the pixel squares just right. Grid will need to be 1 pixel by 1 pixel to be any use to me. Excellent. So now I can see this is going to be 6 by 6 by 9, so I'll have to cut out one of the body pieces. This one doesn't look quite right, so I'm just going to replace it. I think it gives a better impression without it. So next one. 8 tall by 5 wide. Five wide is so awkward. I am going to put... actually... I should really have these right up against the side, shouldn't I? I will leave that one for now, but the rest of them I will put up against the edge of the frame. That's the second frame. Again, the nose pointing up doesn't look right when it's just a single colour, so I'll get rid of that as well. Frame number 3 of the climb. I've just realised I started on the wrong ones. Okay, let's have a look. Yeah, I did, okay, let's see if we can just very quickly redo this one, because I started on the animation for climbing over a lip. Start here. a bit better, I think. Yeah, like that. Okay. Frame 2. Is frame 2 any different? Don't think it is. Oh yeah, it is slightly different. Very, very slightly different. I think we'll skip frame 2, go straight on to frame 3. Looks like this is 10 tool, which is no good at all to us. Because we only have 8 to work with. So we're definitely cutting off the very top. So that's the head and the arms. Except this needs to be blank. The rest of it is just like that. Okay, frame 3. This one does actually look pretty distinct, so I'll do this one. I am, however, going to have to cut off all of its arms and its nose on this one. Levantool. And that's the general shape, we just need to fill it in. Nice easy one this. Right, now we're on to some of the ones where they're squishing up a bit. Can cut off the top two rows for this one. I say it's got to the bit where it's squishing up a bit, but it's kind of the same shape as the last one, isn't it? I think this next one though we can cut off a bit more to get six tall, and that'll give us more of the impression of them crouching together. That's the general outline. And this fourth one on screen at the moment. cut off the bottom and top row. So we kind of start here. End up about there. There's just one more. So what does this look like? I think I need to cut the top and bottom of this one as well. Unless I just leave it as it is. The interesting thing is, does this just play in reverse? I suppose it must do. That's not something we accounted for, and it's gonna have to make a note somewhere. So it kind of oscillates. So you start off playing it this way round. Once you get here, you play it back. Okay. Let's look at these last two. Do they look noticeably different? Yeah, I think they do. I think they look different enough to take the time to do it. How long have I been doing G's instead of C's? Okay, that's all C's, that's all C's. Okay, literally only just started. Okay, and that is done. I am going to save this and carry on, I think. Actually, let's render it out and test it. Oh yeah, I need to update my click handler as well. And I need to update the code so it knows it's a new animation. Just to make sure the animation name is correct. Yes. looks pretty good, don't you think? Except the climbing is going one into the wall. That's another thing I need to fix. Animation. So let's commit this stuff. So this, I think, needs to take a direction in. Actually, it doesn't need to, it just needs to tell it what direction it's facing as soon as it gets set. I suspect I'll need to do that for got stuck in the ceiling. That'll sort itself out once we fix the clipping into the wall. But yeah, I suspect whenever I create any new action, it will need to be told what direction the lemming is facing. Might have to put that into the constructor parameter. Yeah, it did it with walking as well. It didn't, when it went from falling to walking, it didn't correct itself, so let's do that now. So, climber. tooling. And walking. Luckily, walking is probably the most used action, so once we've got the walking sorted out, the other actions, when we go to update them, will be a lot easier to do. Okay. Let's give it a test. So now, when it goes from climbing to walking over the top, it should look the same. Yep, and fooling is good. Walking again is fine. Well, I say fine, it's good enough. And the climbing there is good. Until it gets to the top. So what is next on this sprite sheet? Climbing over the edge, we're not going to do. So it's the umbrella. Not full, is it? I just called it umbrella, didn't I? Floater. Of course it's a floater. Okay, let's get started with these four frames. Actually, I might skip the ones where it's just getting the umbrella out. Start off with this one. Now the trouble is, the umbrella is actually a very, very tall animation. There's like 15, 16 pixels tall. So I might have to simplify, like extremely simplify. But let's start off with this one where it's just a square. So the actual lemming bit is just like 4 wide. So we can put 2 on either side. Ah, that needs to be a space. Did I miscount somewhere? Yep, there we go. Oh wait. That should work. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, okay, that works exactly. And now everything else just gets filled in. Right, this one is going to be tricky. So let's just very much simplify it. Okay, so now I've got 5 blocks for the lemming. So let's take out that arm there. So we can do... this bit. And have it looking like that. I could take out one of these handholds, but the whole point is that the umbrella is like massive. It's like a parachute for the lemming. This. I have 4 blocks left. Yeah, that's not going to be enough even for its head. So I think this time I will shorten the grip on the umbrella. Really don't know what to do with this one. I wonder if I could do like the umbrella rocking sideways. It's going to take up a lot of room there. could shorten the umbrella like this. That gives you more space to play with. Probably move these ones up. So it's like that's his arm, it's his head. That might be as close as I can get. Maybe I can do like feet sticking out. Yeah. It's okay. not sure about this one. I can do the head and I can do the legs, but the arms are going to have to... be absent. What have we done so far? I think that's okay. And then, like, when it restarts, it's almost like the umbrella's trying to pull it away. We don't have to worry about playing one animation for opening it and one for the rest of the time. At these last two animations. I think skip the next one and just do the final one. So we've got a handle coming down here. Got the head there. Got feet here. And the body. Nice and quick one. I am going to call that done. on. Copy. Paste. Better. And this is going to be sorted. Just test out. I need to transform it, don't I? And I need to edit the map again so we've got something to play with. But I'm going to take a quick comfort break. I will be right back. And we're back. Let's just transition this across. There we go. Okay, so number one. Edit the where did my change in the level go? Did I just maybe I committed it? Ah well, nothing major there. But now we are just going to do this. I think that's pretty good. Fast frame may need a bit of a tweak. But I'll leave it as it is for now. So what is next? So we've got these ones, which is panicking. Then panicking more. No, this is splatting into the ground. So we've got here. Free explosion. Which I might just leave off. I think that might be for when you nuke the level and they start making that animation. Or is that just after the countdown's finished and then they do that? And then they get to that one, and then skip down there, skip down there, skip. This one kind of looks like falling into lava. I know, that's definitely the explosion. So let's skip this one. Let's skip the splat for now. Let's just do like a 3-frame one for the blocker. Okay, so we kind of want one that's very definitely looking left, one looking right, and one looking into the center. So let's do something like this. That's looking in one direction. And then just, I guess, copy the exact same thing but looking in the other direction. Oh, this one needs to be centered. So let's just, we know the basic structure, and then once we've got the bottom half done, we can refer back to it. Should we? We don't really have enough room to do the bow-legged thing, but we can see how this looks and tweak it if necessary. Right, so basically want one side to go one short of the top. Side it's two down and then sloping. Two down then sloping. Okay. Looks weird here, but let's save it out and see what we get. Yeah, we might want to do an extra center one, but it's going to be easier to just copy paste that from this. Why can't I get Control C and Control V straight? Okay, let's trash that and open up a new one. Right. So we've got climbing, floating, we don't have bombing, we've got blocking. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 left to do. I think that's about it. Yeah. Head looks a bit weird when he's turned, but that'll do. Yeah, so far today we've done climbing, floating, and blocking, I think. How much work is it to do exploding? Okay, so the next one looks like it's drowning. Haven't got any water just yet, so I'll leave off that. Exploding is a lot of frames. Looks like it's going to be kind of hard, but what about home? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, let's give that a go. Why is there always two changes to sync? Does it only appear on the second one? Anyway, let's give this a refresh and go into the animation editor. How come my backspace is not working anymore? Oh, it's because I haven't got the code to update it. I was so proud of getting backspace to work and then doesn't work with the labels. Done. New. animation name. Animation color. Is a lemming and create. This is 10 tool again, so I can knock one off there and one off there. Frame one done. The great thing about this is each frame gets marginally easier to draw because there's fewer pixels. Well, I say that, this one actually has another row on. So. Let's take that and put it out there. Might look a bit better. This one I can cut off those two, I think, the bottom two lines. It's sort of there, there. like that. Right, this one is only 8, so I could technically fit it in, but I feel like I need to make it smaller by a couple. So we'll start off with 8 to the arms. And just do one leg there. I think that's halfway through the animation. So start off the head again. Just cut the body down by one. This is 1, 2, 3, 4 down and then the legs, so if we make it 3 down and the legs. And last two should be fairly easy. Now the difficult bit is, I don't actually have any logic to play when they hit the exit, but I'll add that to my notes. Maybe I'll add an is exiting flag. Similar to the is exploding flag. yeah, we've got the splat animation to do, the fooling animation. No, not the fooling, we've got splat and exploding, we've got builder. We've got, I can't do that. Digger, miner. That's interesting, let's have a look. So, that's exploding. It's mining, builder, that's builder, that's basher. Where is the basher? So, splat, explode. Build. Can't do that. Dig. There's the bash. There's the mine. All big jobs. So let's see how many frames we did today roughly and how many's left to do. That's 8 there. Another 6. Ten. 18. Yeah, so we did about 26 frames today. And there's 16 just in the splat, and it looks like a similar number for explode, a similar number for build. Ooh, a lot of work ahead of us, but I'm going to leave it there. Yeah. Thank you everyone who came along and watched. I hope you enjoyed yourself. There is a follow and a notify button in the Twitch profile if you want to know when I go live. You can also join our Discord. There's a link to that in the Twitch profile. But yeah, thanks for watching. I hope you had a good time. And whatever else you happen to be doing today, I hope you have a good one. See ya.